Welcome to Show Up and Glow. I'm Jalen. I'm really happy you're here with me today. I'd love for you to take a big, deep breath with me. How's that sound? Just so we can really start settling in to my cozy corner and getting ready to take a walk down memory lane, which feels so nice, you know, like you're really doing it with someone. So, we're just gonna let your brain figure out what numbers I'm gonna count to. I kind of like the guessing game of that. That way you're really aware and present for what we're doing. Okay? Take a big exhale, release everything. And now we're gonna inhale. 2, 3, 4, hold, 2, 3, 4, and exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's it. Just like that. Before we get into today's video, please like and subscribe. That way I know what videos you're liking, what content to keep creating, and you'll be notified every time I drop a new video in my cozy corner for that cozy vibe. So, this all started in 1995. We're going way back. I'm a child of the 90s, and we had certain things that took us by storm, and certain things are still kept by my parents at their lovely home, where I can never get out of my youth, because every time I go back to their house, I'm constantly and I hope to continue to bring some very nostalgic items to talk with and show you on here, because they do something to you, like what we're going to show and tell today. This really does feel like a show and tell. I'm not even going to show you all of it, you know. Lotion or body oil would like to be applied, my bad. But I'm not going to show and tell you, you know, every piece, because that would be, this video would be like 5 hours long. So before we get into it, I gotta ask, did you collect Beanie Babies? And if you did, have you seen the BeanieMania documentary on HBO Max? You know, go take that walk down memory lane at my parents' home to see which ones I have, because watching BeanieMania on HBO Max, the memories and the emotions and the strange but very real feelings I had for certain Beanie Babies that they talked about. Documentary all came back, like just have a couple out here that we're gonna read the tags and explore, you know, with some good sounds and yeah, just, you know, if you had any of these also, please tell me down in the comments. And I also want to hear your favorite ones in the comments. You know, if I don't show them tonight, I only got five out here. If there was a favorite one you had or a special memory you had of collecting Beanie Babies, please tell me. I love it so much. All right, so first up, we got this little cutie cutie. Oh, he's so cutie cutie. I remember taking this guy, Inch. Inch is his name for inchworm. Stop it. Everywhere with me one summer. I remember taking him to visit my family in Illinois. I remember keeping him in my backpack. Now, the tag, for those of you who don't know, is a very big deal. Or at least you were told it was going to be a big deal someday. So he does not have a cover on his tag. He is freeballing it. He is, you know, living life on the edge. But these tags come with a poem about the character. And this is something they talk about in the documentary that blew my mind. Like, everything was so intentional about this from a marketing standpoint. It's pretty amazing. So let me read to you what Inch has to say. It says, well, first it says his date of birth. He was born September 3rd, 1995. So if your birthday was September 3rd, 1995, this is your twin. And it says, Inch the worm is a friend of mine. He goes so slow all the time, itching around from here to there, traveling the world without a care. I love it. And then with three exclamation points at the bottom, it says, just so funny, like, looking back on it, because 1995, visiting websites was very new and not really explored yet, because we didn't find, okay, let me back up. Back in the day when you wanted to collect Beanie Babies, you had to figure out what small shop was going to be selling them that weekend. Usually it was like a Saturday drop. And because these were coming out in 1995 and probably a little earlier with like the originals, nobody used the internet for like classifieds. It was just for like chat rooms. You know what I mean? So what you had to do was, you would look through the newspaper and you would find like a farmer's market, or like there were places like that that we would find them, like farmer stands, but they were like station places, like just small companies, small businesses. And then you would go wait in line in the morning with your family to get whatever Beanie Babies they were getting that day. This guy is Smoochie. I absolutely loved Smoochie. I loved the way he flopped around. I loved his colors. Smoochie's tag is protected. This was when my dad was probably getting very OCD about it and telling us constantly how much money I want to read Smoochie. So we would go stand in line. And sometimes they would have Beanie Babies that you already had. You know, they would get a shipment and you're like, oh, I already had, you know, inch, so you wouldn't collect it. But sometimes they would have Smoochie and you would lose your damn mind. And these were like $4.95 each. Let's see what Smoochie says with his pristine tag. Okay, Smoochie. These poems played a big part in the character building of Beanie Babies, I learned from the documentary. And I just find that so freaking adorable for a child. But these were also grown-ups collecting them who thought that was stinking adorable. Who's up next? Okay. We'll go with a traditional TY Beanie Baby pair. A TY BBB. This one's name is Curly. Curly was one that I would sleep with. His texture is different than the other Beanie Babies. You know, these are like a smooth and he really had curly hair. I also remember getting these Beanie Babies at a time when, like, Hello Kitty and Sanrio was taking over my life. It was like Lisa Frank for a while, and then we switched over to Sanrio. Karubi was like my guy. I was like really into frogs. I don't know what that says about me. And also Basmaru. But when I see this freaking Beanie Baby, I'm like instantly taken back to the mall I grew up going to as a child and going also into Sanrio. I mean, that store was amazing. Curly has a protective case on his tag because I probably thought he was going to be a lot of money someday. What does his tag say? Okay, Curly's date of birth. We got a fellow Aries in the house. April 12th, 1996. So we got a 95, 96, 97. A bear so cute with hair that's curly. You will love and want him surely. To this bear, always be true. He will be a friend to you. Alright. That's Curly, everybody. I have not looked to see who among us are, like, uber valuable, so we're gonna do another video where I show you some that I think are probably worth, like, maybe some money. Maybe they're, like, $25. I don't know. Because I got a whole bag full behind me. And I'm gonna, on camera, look at prices with y'all. And you know what? If you wanna, you wanna bid in the comment section, let's start a bidding war in the comment section. Look at this guy. This guy's name is, what do you think his name is? 1, 2, 3. Lizzie. Lizzie the Lizard. That's good. I loved Lizzie Lizard the same way that I loved Smoochie. I loved the floppiness. I loved the colors. Now, Lizzie's tag is a little worn. Like, Lizzie went a lot of places with me. Let's see what year he was born and what year I got him. You know, the name is kind of like a girly name, Lizzie, but this is definitely a boy. Just, it's a boy. Unless the tag tells me otherwise. Yeah. I mean, it says she in the tag, but this is 2022, and like, I get a vibe that Lizzie just maybe didn't even identify, you know? Okay. Lizzie's date of birth is May 11th, 1995. So, Lizzie and Inch are kind of like OGs. They both have that tagline at the bottom that says, visit our webpage. Did you have Lizzie? And for tonight, the final guy. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, I'm sorry. Could you not be the cutest thing? This is what that documentary talks about. It's like the cuteness. And I am a grown woman and I haven't looked at my Beanie Babies in, like I said, about 2 decades, and yet I look at Bongo right now, and I feel like I'm 12 years old again. It's wild. I loved Bongo. He also went with me everywhere one summer, slept with him, and I probably doubled up, you know, or tripled up on some of these Beanie Babies. I would just, like these would be like, this was a tribe. Like, 1 year, this was like, they were best friends, you know what I mean? Even if they didn't get along, I didn't care. Because you're all sleeping with me, protecting me from God knows what in the middle of the night, and you each have your own strengths. So Bongo also has a very protective tag, but we gotta read it, right? Okay. This won't hurt. Ooh. Did you have Cabbage Patch Dolls? What kind of Cabbage Patch Dolls did you have? I feel like I'm doing something so wrong taking that. Yes, you will, Bongo. One of these days, you'll be worth $1 million. And then we'll be a millionaire. But, like, I won't have to get rid of you, but I'll be a millionaire. And then I'll have this video to remember that I once owned him. But, you know, you had to get rid of him. For many years, I have been asking my dad to, like, get rid of stuff, especially these. I know before I saw that Beanie Baby documentary, I know I asked, why are we keeping these? They didn't turn out to be worth anything. They're just taking up space. And he just wouldn't get rid of them. And now, because that movie, I feel like they could maybe have a resurgence and come full circle again. Or I hope. Like, that would be amazing for all of those Beanie Baby collectors. But if you weren't a part of this ride, there's a lot of hype behind, excuse me, I got the burps, certain Beanie Babies tags. Some tags would be mismatched. Oh, excuse me. I'm only human. We're 20 minutes into this thing. We're not stopping now because of a little gurgle in my throat. Okay. But the hype was like, well, you gotta keep them forever because these are gonna be worth like thousands of dollars because of like the exclusivity of it. Like, you know, there were periods of time where like you couldn't get smoochy anymore. Stuff like that. A like inch became like an OG. Like there were like certain OG Beanie Babies, which I don't have, but I do have some really great collectible ones that we're definitely gonna pull out the next time. The next time around. And see if they're worth anything. Cause these were all like $4.95, $5 back in the 90s. So we got about $20, $25 sitting right here. And they're old, but they like held up. It's pretty impressive for a toy. But if you have not seen BeanieMania on HBO Max, you gotta watch it. It's like 90 minutes. It's really delightful. And I was hesitant at first because I was like, oh, this is gonna But by the end, again, like, it had me seeking out something that my inner child absolutely loved and hadn't got to visit in a really long time. So I hope this video also brought back some memories for you. Please tell me, like, did you wait in line to find certain Beanie Babies? How did your family go about searching for them? Did you have a favorite one? Do you still have them? Oh, also, did you get into Mini Beanie Babies, the McDonald's edition? Because we got those as well, folks. We got bags of Mini Beanie Babies. So did you and your family road trip to as many McDonald's as you could to find the mini ones? You to have those feelings again that we just like push down as adults and forget about. But it feels really good to connect with that part of you. I'm starting to feel so relaxed. How you feeling? Have you been noticing lovely Lady Lava Lamp? What's she up to tonight? Oh, girl. Oh yeah, she just absorbed a bubble. I love it. We'll see what happens next. Sensational. Let's stretch our bodies just a little bit and listen to the clock. How's that sound? To take us out. Oh, might even hear my belly gurgle. Give some good stretches to our upper body, or if you're able to stretch your lower body as well, Let's do that. Let's just listen to the clock for just a little bit with each other. Thank you for spending this time with me today. I hope you're feeling more calm and relaxed and proud of yourself for taking just a little bit of time out of your day for you. Thank you for being here. I'll see you again real soon.